Hey guys, I'm going to check the list, please. Pay attention. Leandra Lopez. She's not here. Betty Silva.
Present.
Astrid Grande. Astrid Grande.
Present.
María Carranza.
Present.
Suani David. Alex Morales.
Present.
Ángel Osorio.
Present.
Ángel Vázquez.
Present.
Cristian Mejía.
Present.
Diego Godoy. Henry Seguirre.
Present.
José Gómez.
Present.
Leonardo Calderón.
Present.
Next. Okay, guys. Exercise number 5. Answer the question. Follow the example. Letter A. Letter A, would you like to go to the party? Would you like to go to the party? Affirmative answer, yes, I would like to go to the party. Letter B, Henry Zahir. Would Berta like to play tennis with you?
Espera, espera.
Okay. Would Berta like to play tennis with you? Negative. Negative answer. Yeah. Give me a negative answer.
No.
No.
I don't go.
No, she, about Berta. The description is about Berta. Okay? No.
She don't would.
She would not, but she couldn't. Uh-huh. Not she couldn't.
Play tennis.
Okay, no, she wouldn't like to play tennis with you. Okay? No, she couldn't, or no, she will not play tennis with you. Letter C, Christian Mejia. Does your answer like to eat cheese? Please, affirmative answer. Give me affirmative answer.
Yes.
Yes. Look, 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 look. We use does. Yes.
Eat.
Eat. Excellent.
Do. Do.
Does.
Do.
Like. Excellent.
Do.
Do.
Eat.
Eat.
Cheese.
Cheese. Excellent. Next. Maria Carranza. Good James like to drink tea. Affirmative answer, please. Give me affirmative answer.
Yes.
Continue.
Yes, he. Like.
Mm-hmm. Are you sure it's like or go like?
Go like.
Uh-huh. Go like.
To drink tea.
To drink tea. Thank you. Yes, he would like to drink tea. A él le encantaría tomar té. Okay, guys, please checking in your textbook. Exercise number 5. Okay, exercise number 6. Complete the sentence. Giving opinions, asking and answering. Giving opinions. Asking and answering. Asking. What do you think about Chinese food? Answering. I think it's delicious. What does Helen think about rectals? She thinks they're dangerous. What's your opinion about soap operas? In my opinion, they are boring. Okay, chicos, entonces fíjense. Cuando usted va a preguntar a la primera persona, a la segunda persona del singular es you, o si lo va a hacer a la primera, segunda y tercera del plural, que es we, you, and they, entonces vamos a utilizar what, do, y de ahí va a ir el personal pronoun, ¿de acuerdo? ¿Verdad? Y de ahí le va a decir think, ¿qué piensas tú acerca de? Y después de este think about, usted escribe sobre lo que quiere preguntar, qué es lo que piensa la persona. ¿Ok? For example, what, Astrid, what do you think about romantic music? What do you think about romantic music? La otra la veo bien enamorada. Madre, ¿qué piensa usted sobre la música romántica? Entonces usted diría, I I look. I Astrid, what do you think about romantic music? What do you think? Ángel Osorio, what do you think about romantic music?
I think it's beautiful.
Beautiful. Thank you. Okay. Copy, guys.
En el libro. Textbook.
No, la última la copio en el cuaderno. La otra la completa en el libro. Ajá. ¿Y qué sucede cuando nosotros respondemos para la tercera persona? ¿Qué pasa con el verbo? Se le agrega la letra S al verbo. She thinks. Tercera persona. Y cuando le pregunta a la tercera persona, o sea, él o ella utiliza does, the auxiliar does. ¿Ok? No do, sino does. Okay, exercise number 7. Look at the pictures and answer the question as in the example. Example, letter A. Do you like that t-shirt? No, I don't. I think it's ugly. No, dice, no, 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 no. Yo pienso que es fea, que es horrible. Eso está diciendo. T-shirt. Letter B. Henry Zaguirre, what do you think about my hat?
I think.
Okay, wait, wait, wait. What do you think about my hat? I think or I don't like.
I don't like.
I don't like it. I don't like it. Okay. I think. Ahora sí, digan.
I think it's so big.
It's so big. It's too big. I don't like it. I think it's too big. It's too big. No me gusta porque pienso que es demasiado grande. Okay. Letter C. Letter C. Leonardo Calderón. Do you like that dress? ¿Te gusta este vestido? O sea, para la chica. Para la chica, ¿verdad? Solo para la novia, pues, si le gusta, lo regalaría. No. ¿No?
No, I don't.
No, I don't. Ok.
¿Y?
Ajá. What do you think? ¿Qué piensa usted? Okay. No, I don't. I think it's old fashioned. Pienso que es demasiado viejo, pasado de moda. Okay, letter D. Cristian Mejía. Do you think this feel is nice? Do you think this feel is nice?
No.
No?
I don't.
Mm-hmm.
Like.
No, I don't. Uh-huh. What do you think?
Yo pienso
it is frightening. I think it's frightening. Okay, guys. Exercise number 8. Write the question for this answer. Okay. We have the question, but I need to create, or I need to write the question. I don't, no, I don't like Japanese food. Japanese food. What is the question, Leonardo?
Que si le gusta la comida japonesa.
Ay, ¿cómo la diríamos?
Yes.
No, the question. You need to use the auxiliary do.
I like Japanese eat food.
No. O sea, usted va a preguntar, ahí ya le dieron la respuesta que no le gusta la comida japonesa, pero ¿cómo le va a preguntar a usted que si le gusta la comida japonesa?
Do you like Japanese food?
Perfecto. Do you like Japanese food? No, I don't like Japanese food. Alex Morales. Next. The answer is no, I couldn't. No, I couldn't like to eat a hot dog. What is the question, Alex Morales? Okay, repeat again.
I would lie.
Are you sure? It's question. No answer. Please think. Yes. Esto lo estuvimos viendo hace un par de días. Cuando usted iba a preguntar con el Google, ¿cómo se hacía la pregunta? ¿Te encantaría o te gustaría comer tal cosa? ¿Te encantaría hacer tal cosa? ¿Cómo se pregunta? Angel what Henry. Okay, repeat again.
What would?
In this case, más directo, porque no le vamos a preguntar qué te gustaría, sino de un solo. ¿Le gustaría?
Would you like?
Ah, would you like? Would you like? Would you like? Y aquí abajo tiene la respuesta. Would you like? Would you like to eat a hot dog? Would you like to eat a hot dog? Then le pone ahí y aquí ya está la respuesta. Wait, guys, wait 2 minutes, please. Okay, guys. Next. Dancer. No, my friends. My friends don't like to surf. What is the question? Mr. Gomez.
Do your friends.
Your friends. Possessive. Remember. Uh-huh.
Like.
Like. Infinitive.
To write.
To serve.
Try.
To serve. Only. Like to serve. Okay. Next. Maria Carranza. Dancer. Now he couldn't. Now he couldn't like to talk to you. Talk to you. What is the question, Maria Carranza? Look. We use do or good?
Good.
Pregunto, ¿qué vamos a usar nosotros? ¿Do or good?
Good.
Good. Ok, create the question, please.
Would.
Good.
Good. Like.
Good you or he?
He.
Ah, good he. Like.
Like.
Do. What is the verb?
Talk.
Talk to me.
To.
Would he like to talk to me? No, he wouldn't like to talk to you. A él no le gustaría hablarte. ¿Le gustaría a él hablar conmigo? No. ¿O hablarme a mí? No. No le gustaría hablarle. Okay, guys. Learn about the use of indefinite pronouns and complete the sentences. Indefinite pronouns. Definite pronouns. Okay, guys, indefinite pronouns. Indefinite pronouns refer to things or people without mentioning what or who they are. O sea, los pronombres indefinidos se refieren a cosas o a gente con la que no mencionamos o quienes están ahí, ¿verdad? Entonces vamos a decir, to talk about people we use. Cuando nosotros vamos a hablar de gente, nosotros vamos a usar anybody or anyone. Somebody or someone. Nobody or no one. Okay? Anybody, nadie. Anyone, nadie. Somebody, alguien. Or someone, alguien. Nobody, ninguno. To talk about things, we use anything, something, or nothing. Anything, cualquier cosa, something, alguna cosa, or nothing es nada. Ninguna, nada, pues, referente a las cosas. Use somebody, or someone, or something in affirmative sentences. O sea, estas tres palabras, somebody, someone or something, nosotros lo vamos a usar en oraciones afirmativas. For example, somebody told me that. Alguien me dijo esto. Alguien me contó esto. She brought something for me. Ella compró algo para mí. Someone is studying French. Alguien está estudiando francés. Use nobody, no one, or nothing in negative sentences. The main verb has to be positive. Nobody arrived. Nadie vino. I know nothing. Yo no sé nada. I invited no one. Yo no invité a nadie. Okay, guys. Esto ustedes ya lo tienen en la el ejercicio número 9, exercise number 9. Learn about the use of indefinite pronouns and complete a sentence. Okay, but complete with the words with have in this table. Complete con las palabras que tenemos en estas tablas. Complete esa tabla que usted tiene ahí. Aleja, Ángel Yair, yo no lo veo trabajando. Solo hablando se la lleva con otra gente. Por eso cuando le pregunto ni sabe lo que hay que decir. Okay, guys. Use anybody, anyone, or anything in interrogative sentences. For example, is anybody here? No hay nadie aquí. Es lo que nosotros sabemos decir en español. No hay nadie aquí. Did you eat anything? ¿Comiste algo? ¿No comiste nada? Is anyone at school? No hay nadie o no está nadie en la escuela. Es lo que popularmente nosotros sabemos decir, ¿verdad? Se va la negative para las preguntas. Okay. Let's continue it. Exercise number 10. Use the words from the box to complete the sentences. Box, the box. With the words anything, anyone, somebody, and nobody. Letter A, I'm so tired. Can anyone help me with this box? Anyone help me with this box? Estoy tan cansado. ¿Podría alguien ayudarme con esta bolsa? Eso es lo que está diciendo. The door is open. There is somebody at home. The door is open. There is somebody at home. La puerta está abierta. Hay alguien en el hogar. I won the lottery. Nobody will believe me. Nobody will believe me. Yo gané la lotería, nadie me lo creerá. Oh, I forgot to bring the snacks. Oh, I forget, yo olvidé traer los churros o los bocadillos. And you, ¿y tú? Did you bring anything? ¿No trajiste nada? Le dice. Did you bring anything? ¿No trajiste nada? Okay, guys. Exercise 11, and learn about the use of the pronouns one and once. One and once. The pronouns one, once, can refer to people or things. They are used to avoid the repetition of nouns mentioned previously. They are placed after an adjective. O sea, se puede referir a personas, adjetivos, y son usados cuando nosotros estamos para repetir algo, ¿verdad? Como lo repetimos mucho previamente. Entonces, estos van ubicados después de un adjetivo. After an adjective. Use one for singular noun. One for singular noun. Example. Which car will you buy? I'll buy the red one. Which dress do you like? I like the small one. Me gusta una pequeña. Eso es lo que está diciendo. Me gusta un carro rojo, o voy a comprar un carro rojo. Eso es lo que le estaba diciendo allá. Which dress do you like? I like the blue one. Me gusta el azul. Ahora, el uso del use once for plural nouns, que es para el plural. Entonces tenemos ejemplo. Which books do you need? Which books do you need? I need the science ones. Entonces necesito uno de ciencia, es lo que le está diciendo. Which pillows are yours? The big ones, unos grandes, dice que es lo que necesita de almohada. Okay, guys, complete. Okay, guys. Exercise number 12. Look at the pictures. Answer the question as in the example. For example, which shoes? Which shoes? Which shoes will you wear? Which shoes will you wear? Which shoes will you wear? I'll wear the brown ones. Aquí lo que está diciendo. Yo me pondré unos cafés, eso es lo que está diciendo ahí, sin necesidad de mencionar nuevamente lo que es los zapatos. Ok, letter B. Which sweater are you going to wear? Are you going to wear? Henry, which sweater are you going to wear?
I am going.
Remember, use going to. O sea, fíjense aquí, de acuerdo a la pregunta, miren. Vamos. I am going to. I am going to. Where?
Where to?
The blue or the white?
The blue sweater.
The blue. Yeah. One or ones?
One.
Porque solo es uno. Recuerde que no vamos a mencionar nuevamente el artículo en este caso, sino que lo que estamos haciendo es el uso de one and ones. Entonces dice, I am going to wear uno azul. Ya se sobreentiende que estamos hablando del suéter. Letter C. Which is your chair? Astrid, which is your chair?
Espérame, profe.
Una es de madera y otra es de metal.
Bueno, voy a...
Oh, plastic. My chair is... My chair is wooden or plastic? Leonardo? Wooden or plastic? Okay, guys. My chair is the wooden one. Angel Osorio, which car is Robert going to buy? New or old?
He's going to buy
to buy? The old one. Okay, thank you. Okay, guys, finish for today. See you soon, guys. Bye bye. Take care.
Bye.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.